Well, I guess there's some people that are still interested in this program. Anyway, SketchUp Make 2017 was the last version of SketchUp Make, which was a free version of SketchUp that you could use on a desktop. Now, you could still use SketchUp for free, but it's in something known as a web-based application, and I don't necessarily like these. Delving a tab into the history of this program, it was initially created by a company called Atlas Software in August of 2000. This company then got bought out by Google in 2006, and for while, it was a program that Google maintained, and then Google sold it to a company called Trimble in 2012. Since then, a lot has changed with this program. In fact, the logo you were seeing earlier is not the logo that is used anymore. And the modern version of this program is a subscription service, at least for the desktop version. Anyway, I also want to mention that this program is used quite a bit in industrial applications and stuff like engineering and whatnot. But I think we should just delve into the program, shall we? First of all, before I actually try out SketchUp, I want to note that this also came with Style Builder and Layout, but these require a pro subscription. Anyway, upon opening this up, it tells us that SketchUp Make hasn't been updated since 2017, making it vulnerable to security issues and to get a subscription for SketchUp Pro. We can apparently take 10% off with the United States dollar, euro, or Great British pound, but where is the Canadian dollar option? What if I want to move to Canada in the future? We also have the license tab, which gives us a serial number, which is generally just universal for all these SketchUp Make versions. And we also have our templates. I'm going to use the metric system since one, it's default, and two, it's the international standard measurements. We also have a few other templates here, but I'm not going to use those. Anyway, let's start using SketchUp now. Anyway, upon opening up the program here, we have this neat man. He doesn't have a face. We're going to go to the about here for a second so I can show you. This is version 17 of SketchUp Make. Anyway, we can get rid of this man by hitting the delete key or alternatively through the eraser. This is just a placeholder for this template. Anyway, I'm going to draw some lines here, which can be a tad bit tedious if you are not used to these 3D planes. Just to make sure I was doing this properly, I went to use the orbit tool, and now let's use the push and pull tool. And this was a patented thing that was in SketchUp at the time. It was a pretty cool feature. We have a wide selection of tools such as a zoom, arc, measuring tape, rectangle, polygon, freehand, 3D text, circle, label, and we have a paint tool which has a wide variety of textures. Anyway, I'm gonna go save this so that we can then go move on to some of the other tools I haven't documented yet, which I will do in the older SketchUp files that I have, because why not? I used its program back in the day, I have some nostalgia for it, so why not show some of my older things? And by the way, I will say that some of these old things I'm not gonna necessarily show because some of these really, really old things are pretty much nuclear waste, just like all the other things I made in 2019. To start, I'm going to open up this car that I designed in SketchUp when I was in 7th grade. It's not very great. It turns out that this was locked, and I needed to unlock it. We have move, rotate, scale, and offset. That's generally it for the program. I want to do a few reflections on this program. I enjoyed using it back in the day, mainly as somebody that just liked to mess around with like making 3D models and stuff. It was like a nice thing to use. I also liked to 3D print things back in the day, and in fact I still have some of those 3D printed things, even though the quality isn't as great as it is these days. I don't really have much else to say. One last thing, if you want to try this program out, I put it on the Internet Archive, so you can try it for yourself. It's totally free. It doesn't need a serial because it's a free version of the program. Feel free to enjoy it yourself. Anyways, with that, thanks for watching. I'll see you next week. Bye.